So it is on a busy street, but I do not hear any street noise ever. But it is right in the middle of the old city. So you kind of have tons of restaurants and spas and everything. I just had an incredible foot massage right down the street. This is the front of the hotel, Yu Chiang Mai. It is actually the old governor's mansion, and they converted it into a hotel, but they did keep part of the charm of the original. So when you're in the lobby, the spa, the reading room, that is all part of the original governor's house. And then the rooms, of course, were added on too. So when you get here, you have this beautiful little walkway into the hotel. And you'll go to reception and they'll give you a welcome drink as they sign you in. They do have bikes here, and the bikes are free to use. You just sign them out. And the best time to go biking here is in the morning, because the streets are not so busy and you can bike through the old town and see all the temples. They also have quite an incredible spa here, and they have very good prices. So let's start with the dining room. So you just walk this way, and it's called Eat and Drink. And I actually haven't been up to drink yet. It is up on the second floor and it's like a rooftop bar. This is where breakfast is every day, and it's quite nice. The choices are rather limited, but breakfast is included in the room, so you can't complain. But it's a lot of eggs and a lot more eggs, so after about 5 days you get a little bit tired of eggs. And then little lobby area right here, they got some board games and you can just chill. I found this area very helpful last night. I could come in from the night market and just kind of rest before I went back in. The market was very busy, and the Sunday night market runs right in front of the hotel. We'll go up here. We have a little library and a spa. So this is the reading room, and again, this is the part that is the old governor's mansion. So you can see they've kept it very traditional. All the dark Thai woodwork, very comfortable sofas to sit and read on. Then there is a spa check-in right here. And that is the Yu Spa Chiang Mai. And we won't go down there because people are probably having treatments. And now we're back to the check-in and reception area, which brings us to the pool area. It's a small pool, but it's very nice. And there are pool access rooms, which is what I have. So I'll show you that in a minute. Lovely greenery. It's a very quiet. I've slept here for 3 nights now and I haven't heard anything. It is beyond quiet and just lovely. Tanning area over here. And here's the main pool. And then these are the pool access rooms. So they actually have like a little private plunge pool with little steps going down, and I'll show you better when we get to my room. Welcome to my room, room 106. I only got the single pool access room. I was trying not to spend too much money, and I knew in Chiang Mai I was gonna be very busy. So the better pool access room is called the Superior, and it has like a bathtub and a couch, and I just didn't see the need for all that. So the bed, I did not have maid service today, I apologize, but the bed is very comfortable. I did ask for a room away from the road, and I made all the difference because I do not hear a thing. I love the cute little phone. Like I said, there's little bits of the charm kind of everywhere. And then the door is laid out to your private plunge pool. And then there's a nice sofa out here where I was reading earlier today, reading The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. It's extremely good and a perfect vacation read. Lots of outlets, and they also have the outlets for plugging in your electrical devices. A cute little TV. Every day we get free water. They put it in this cute little burlap sack. And there's a nice little mini bar. You get one complimentary drink per day. And I keep my water in there too, so it stays nice and cold. Got a nice little bench with my dirty laundry. And then nice little closet with some drawers and those packing cubes. Oh, I love them. Got a little flashlight, an umbrella. Everything you can possibly need is here. And this is my bathroom. Got a beautiful stand-up rain shower. Nice toilet. Gotta have the Thailand bum gun, right? Nice storage space. I love when hotels have a nice little makeup mirror. Nice sink area. Some beautiful Yu Chang Ma ropes. I decided on my Thailand trip, I was gonna see which hotel I stayed at had my favorite robes. They also give us indoor and outdoor slippers. So these are the outdoor slippers. And then over here we have the indoor slippers. Okay, for solo female travelers, I never leave home without my doorstop. I don't think you need it so much in Thailand because it is such a safe country. But if I'm anywhere else, and I have used it here just because it never leaves my suitcase. But I urge you to buy one of these. You can buy them on Amazon. I just use the doorstop here. But when I've been places like Mexico and places where I'm not quite as comfortable, you can put batteries in. So if anybody even tries to open your door, not only will it not allow it, but it will alert you with an alarm. So it's a great little single woman travel thing. So, this is my hotel at the Yu Chang Mai. Like I said, with the exception of breakfast being a little redundant and not all that great, which I find the case with most hotels that include breakfast, I would highly rate this property probably a 4.7 out of 5. I have enjoyed my stay here. I do have two more nights to sleep here and looking forward to it. And then I head to Phuket. And I will do another review when I get there.